Okay, so I think we're going to kick things off. Hi, everyone. Thanks for taking the time to join our Automate Your Practice with Halaxy webinar today, which is the fourth and final webinar as part of our new onboarding series. It's really great to see everyone here today, and I think I can see a few familiar faces in the chat, so that's very nice. My name's Shanna. I'm responsible for all things marketing here at Halaxy. With me today is our learning specialist, Rhea, who will be leading today's webinar. Thank you, Rhea. We also have Kinjal, Josh, and Sarisha from our customer service team on the call. They'll be answering any questions you may have about the topic of Halaxy automations today. So feel free to put any questions you have in the chat, and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. Back to the big picture of today's session. This webinar will take a deeper look at some of the topics we've covered in our previous webinars with a focus on how you can use Halaxy to automate your routine tasks and eliminate manual data entry, helping you increase efficiency and reduce your workload. This helps you save up to an hour on admin every day so you can focus on what matters most, patient care. We talk about that a lot at Halaxy. We're going to start today's webinar by showing you how Halaxy automatically creates the correct invoice for any billing or funding arrangement, including Medicare, all from your calendar and in just one click. From there, we'll look at how to set up your billing for Medicare and Halaxy, auto payments, custom funders, and how to run reports and even set up campaigns. Rhea will go into these topics in a bit more detail in just a moment. And don't worry, no matter where you are in your Halaxy journey, whether you're just getting started using Halaxy or you're looking for a bit of a refresher, I promise that you'll leave today's session having learned something new. I think I always do from this session, so big thanks to Rhea there. Okay, with that out of the way, I'm going to hand it over to our learning specialist, Rhea. Rhea, thanks for taking the time today. I'm really excited to learn how we can use Halaxy to automate our practices today.
Thank you, Shane. Hi, everyone. My name is Rhea. I am the learning specialist here at Halaxy. I'm really excited to be here, especially for the topic we have today, which is about automating your admin tasks with a focus on clinical billing. So an hour you spend on admin could have been an hour seeing patients. And one of Halaxy's greatest features is automating all your repetitive tasks to give you back valuable time for the work that matters most, which is treating patients. So we'll be building on the main features discussed in previous webinars. Michelle, I see that you asked the question how you can watch previous webinars. Shane is dropping a link to our website where you can watch all the previous recordings. So if you didn't attend those, do check them out. But we are building on some of the main features. So we trust you're already familiar with the basics as we delve into more advanced topics. So I'll just quickly run you through the learning goals for today's webinar. So the first thing we'll do is learn how to automate Medicare billing. So we'll learn how to set up Medicare for appointments to automate your invoicing. You'll never have to enter claim details or for every appointment, and you can always track, you'll always stay on top of referral usage for every appointment. The next topic is how to automate payments and rebates. So you can schedule payments and your Medicare rebates so you can keep your financial tasks completely hands-free and you can focus on your clinical work. So you can automate your credit card payments. You can also automate your Medicare, DVA, and bulk billing rebates. Third is you can automate custom billing. If you are providing services that you bill to third-party organizations, you can set up custom billing so you can tailor your Halaxy invoices and patient claims exactly how you need them for these specific services. So if you are outside of Australia, this is also really good to know that you can structure your billing the way you need them. So the fourth and last topic is how to automate reports and campaigns. So these two are closely linked. Halaxy offers reporting for different parts of your practice, so you can get clear oversight over your performance as both a healthcare provider and as a business. If you run the same types of reports on a regular basis, you can save reports and automate them to generate automatically on a schedule. Then you can use campaigns to send bulk emails or bulk SMS to patients or professional contacts. And by using reports to generate a target audience list, the campaigns can be scheduled to send once or at a regular schedule as well. So by setting up automations, Halaxy sets you up to have a more efficient practice. So these are just some of the automation features from Halaxy. There's so much more that you can automate. And if you want to learn more, you can visit our help guide. Sorry, let me just hide this taskbar. Not hiding. Anyway, so you can learn more by visiting our help guide at support.halaxy.com. We have hundreds of tutorial articles, step-by-step instructions, video tutorials to help you learn how to use every aspect of Halaxy. We also have the Resource Center, which you can access by clicking on the Help and Resources button in the lower left corner of Halaxy. This pulls up quick support. This is also plugged into our help guide, so you can quickly search for articles straight from Halaxy. And we also have news. Our latest news are added there for you to read. We also have some of our video tutorials and our webinars embedded there as well. If you want to follow along today's webinar, you can log into your Halaxy account now, or if you don't have one yet, you can create an account. It's free. You don't need to have a credit card, or, you know, there's no lock-in contract. You can just sign up, and you can put the two windows side by side so you can follow along with this webinar. We also have a few reminders that some features in this webinar will require a verified profile. So we really want to promote authentic practices in Halaxy. So there are some features that are locked until you get your profile verified. For example, SMS, payments, processing payments, and Medicare claims. Some of those are locked until you get your profile verified. It really takes only a few minutes. And Shane's just going to drop a link to the Halaxy help guide article on how you can get your profile verified. Some of these features might also require Halaxy credits. So anything that involves SMS, you pay for those using Halaxy credits. If you don't know what Halaxy credits are, you buy them in packs, and this is what you use to pay for certain add-on features. The main software of Halaxy is free. You can have as many patients, appointments, invoices as you need. But there are just add-on features that you pay for, such as SMS, processing Medicare claims. It's just one credit for a successful transaction. And one credit can be as low as 15 cents. So Shane's also dropping a link to our help guide on all about Halaxy credits. If you want to participate in this webinar, we have the chat tab here in Zoom. Just click that. We have Sarisha, Kinjal, and Josh from the customer service team joining us today. So we just want to remind everybody to keep questions relevant to our topic today. If you have any other complex questions or something related to your situation, we recommend that you email or call the service team instead so they can resolve your issue much faster. So if everybody's ready, let's get started. So the first thing we'll talk about is Medicare billing. So if you can we're just going to jump straight into Halaxy. So as we've mentioned in our previous webinars, if you want to set up your invoice, it's already automated every time you create an appointment. So let's say here in your calendar, I'm just going to quickly create an appointment. Sorry, let's go with this location. And we will add our patient. And if you want a Medicare fee, in Halaxy, Medicare is seamlessly integrated, so you can submit and process claims all within the platform. So Halaxy has preset fees already. You don't have to set up each Medicare fee with its own item code. You can import it straight from the appointment. So from here, let's search for Medicare. Or you can use the item code if you're already familiar with it. So let's just click on the fee to import it. If you want to charge a gap fee, make sure to edit the amount and just add on the gap fee on top of that. So for example, you're going to have this to, I don't know, 300 or something, but let's just keep this at the moment to, let's say you're going to bulk bill. You can just keep the amount the same as the rebate. So you can also adjust the duration. If that's going to be around 30 minutes, you can change that as well. So I'm going to click import fee, and that already imports the fee to your practice. You can reuse that. And this also sets up the billing structure for Medicare. So I'll show you how that works. When you click save, you'll see that here, the patient, you've added the Medicare fee, and you also have a Medicare claim section here where you can add the patient's Medicare card number. So let's just quickly add that. I'm going to copy it. And we'll save it. So their Medicare card number is now saved to their patient profile. So the next time you create an appointment for this same patient, their card details are going to be entered automatically. So you don't have to keep entering their Medicare card details. And as you can see, when you create this appointment, you've already created your clinical notes for this appointment, and you've also created an invoice. So if you just click on that invoice, it'll show your invoice. It'll show that your invoice is already configured for Medicare. So you have the claim details here for the patient. And you also have your identification here. So you can just click this pencil icon next to provider number, and you can just add your provider number here. So again, the next time you create an appointment with a Medicare fee for any patient, this identification number is going to be on every invoice as well. So if you want to check how that works, so if you let's go back to the calendar. So on the upper left, let's click on the Halaxy logo, takes you back to the calendar. And say next week, this same patient is going to have another appointment. So say another appointment here. Let's save that. As you can see, the Medicare claim is here. And if you click here, your identification is here. And also you can quickly add your patient's referral here. So say, I'm sure there are a lot of psychologists on the call. We have a lot of psychologists who use Halaxy. You can even add like the mental health treatment plan here. So you can already import this preset referral. So let's say this first one, you have the 6 appointments. And let's add a referring practitioner. And let's add that and save. So you can also see that when you add a referral, the number of appointments are tracked, and the referral is automatically applied to the appointment that has a Medicare fee. So everything is automated for you. Also, I just want to show the other advantage of using the Medicare presets. It's, give me one sec. Sorry. So when you use Halaxy presets, we also keep the rebates, the pricing and the rebates updated. So every time MBS releases updates to their pricing, we update them for you, and you don't have to go into each fee one by one to update them. So to do that, on the sidebar on the left, click finances and then click fees. And you'll see here on the top right, there's a button here called update fees. If you click that, all of the fees that have pricing updates or rebate updates, they'll be listed here, and you just have to click update here one by one. So it's that easy. It's all automated for you. The other thing that Halaxy also does is the request you can send a request of assignment of benefit. So for you practitioners who do telehealth and you bulk bill, Medicare requires you to obtain an approval of bulk bill benefit from your patients. So a lot of times you've had to send an email or send a text to them requesting that, or sometimes you have to have them sign in person. So in Halaxy, you can do that at the click of a button. So just going back to our appointment, let's just open the invoice real quick. So here, this is a bulk bill appointment, right? So the amount is the same as the rebate. So before you can process the rebate, you're going to have to get that approval of bulk bill. So if you could, you're going to have to send this invoice to your patient. And if it is a bulk bill appointment where the rebate is equal to the total amount, there will automatically be a button that says assign benefit. So to send this, all you have to do is click the top right, this paper plane icon. And this is where you can send the invoice. So you can choose to do this over email or over SMS. SMS is obviously much faster. People have their phones on them all the time. It's easier for them to just click on the button. I'll show you how to send this by email. So to send them the email, you have to send them a link to their invoice summary. So to do that, you have to put the link here as a dynamic term. So, I mean, you can type it out or you can just select them from this dynamic terms toolbar here. So, it's the payment link. So when you send this dynamic term payment link, it automatically converts into the actual link that takes them to the invoice where they can assign the benefit. So you don't have to do this like manually every time. You can create a communication template. This is something that we've demonstrated in a previous webinar, where you can create an email or SMS template that you can reuse every time, and it's automatically personalized for your recipients as well. Shane can drop the link to the help guide article on how you can create a communication template. So to show you how that works, give me one sec. Just to show you how it works with a communication template. So let's create an appointment and say this one. And let's create our, put our invoice and we'll send it. So when we send the invoice, I have a communication template here for assignment of benefit. And when it does that, it populates the message with the template. And you can also, we recommend adding instructions for your patient on how to assign the benefit. And it shows here, like, open your invoice in this link, and this is where the link is going to be. So to show you how that looks like, when your patient receives the email, it looks like this. So the payment link dynamic term converts into this. And when they click that, they're taken to this invoice summary where they can click assign benefit. And when they click that, they can give their approval, signed by, and then when they click save, that assignment of benefit is going to be on your invoice. It's going to be here, which you can download as well. So that's, that is the Medicare billing. So just a question, have any of you registered for Medicare online claiming already? Because to be able to do all this Medicare billing, you have to register for a Medicare location ID. Has everybody registered? Oh, that's great. To anyone who hasn't registered yet, yes, there's some of you who haven't yet. So the key to Medicare claiming is the Medicare location ID. So you'll find that here on the sidebar, click personal and then locations. So your Medicare location ID, you need to have one for each practice location. And this is what identifies you as a Halaxy. This identifies you with Medicare that you are a Halaxy user. So Medicare knows that you are a genuine registered practitioner submitting claims. And this also tells, this also registers your bank account details that all your rebates should go to this bank account registered with this ID. So if you haven't done that yet, if you go to personal and locations, you'll see here under your location, there's a link here, request a location ID. And there we have an we have a comprehensive video tutorial on this. And Shane's just going to drop the link to the help guide article with step-by-step instructions and a video tutorial on how to register for Medicare claims. This is also for DVA, for bulk billing, for Eclipse. If you are a specialist, you can also use the Medicare location ID for that. Okay, so now that we know how to structure our Medicare billing, we'll move on to the next topic, which is how to automate your payments and rebates. So now that our invoices are automatically configured, let's automate payments and rebates. In Halaxy, you can request your patients to provide their card details and Medicare details through the patient intake form. So in our previous webinars, we showed you how to set up a patient intake form to request your patient's details. And it looks like this. This is the patient intake form, and you can include their payment details to if they can add their credit card details here. And you can also ask them for their Medicare card details, which they can enter here. And you can also add their referrals. And when they submit the intake form, their patient profile is automatically populated with all of these. So you don't even have to enter these manually into the appointment. If you are able to get them to get your patient to submit the intake form before their appointment, all you have to do is create the appointment, basically. And then the invoice will already have their claim details and their credit card details. And then you'll be able to automate payments and rebates. So just a reminder that payments and rebates requires verified profiles. So please get your Halaxy profile verified. So let's start by scheduling automatic payments. So let's use this. So on the sidebar, click, we'll go to settings and then payments. And under here, you see these two sections here, payment processing and rebate processing. So as of right now, the whole group is set to manual payments. And that means that everybody in the practice group has to go in each individual invoice and process payment from there. But what we want to do is schedule these payments to process by themselves. So this only works, payments processing only works if you have your patient's credit card details on file. So it's really, it's important that you, if you can get them to submit them on the intake form, you can even require them to add their credit card details on the patient intake form. So let's say we want to schedule payments for the whole group. So let's click the pencil icon here under payments processing. And you'll see we have different settings here. So as of right now, we have it on manual processing. The first automatic option is to set it to automatic after appointment starts. So you can set this to, let's say, 5 minutes. And that means 5 minutes into the appointment, the patient's credit card is going to get charged already. If you want the patient to be charged as soon as the appointment starts, just set this to 0 minutes. The second automatic option is daily. So this processes all your invoices once every day. So you can choose what time you want to process. So let's say if you want it to be the end of day, you can set this to maybe 5 p.m. or 7 p.m. So you make sure all your appointments are finished. Then for daily processing, you also have additional options. So which appointments do you want to process? So there's past appointments. So let's say I'm processing at 7 p.m. This processes invoices from 7 p.m. the previous day to 7 p.m. today. So it's just all past appointments. Whole day means today, all 24 hours of just today. So let's say it's June 3rd, all payments for all of June 3rd, including those, like if let's say you have an a pre-scheduled appointment at 8 p.m., it's going to include that as well. So this also allows you to charge before the appointment. So if you're charging for a whole day, you can add a process schedule where it's like, if it's same day, it's just charge for all invoices today, or you can set to 1 day prior, 2 days prior, 3 days prior. So this means you can get upfront payments before before the appointment, and you can reduce no-shows, or if people cancel at the last minute, at least you can still charge them. And so you can also select any fees you want to exclude from this. And let's click save. Let's say I just want for past appointments. So let's maybe process at 7 p.m. and I'm going to save that. So now all your payments will automatically be processed at 7 p.m. every day. So for rebates, it's similar. So it's the same for group. Click the payment pencil icon. So it's similar. There's automatic after appointment starts, or you want it automatic daily. But with this, it's really just daily. You can't charge prior to an appointment, obviously, for rebate processing. This will only be processed. Auto rebate processing will only be done for paid invoices. So you should automate your rebates. Maybe you can do this after. So after 7 p.m. So maybe I will put this at 2000 hours and then I'll click save. So as with many settings in Halaxy, you can schedule payments and rebates for your entire group or for specific locations or specific practitioners if they have their own preferences. You can set different settings for every different one. It can be as tailored as you need it to be. So all you need to do, so for example, payments processing, let's say you have a practitioner who only practices half day. So they want to process their payments earlier. So you can click add new and say automatic daily. So under level, click individual and say just for this practitioner, I want to schedule it for say 1 p.m. and you can save that. So you'll see that this practitioner has their own settings as well. Okay, so we've done Medicare and the auto payments and rebates. We'll move on to our third topic, which is how to automate custom billing. So if a patient's treatment is paid for by someone else, so there's an organization, employer, an institution, a funding body, you can set up custom billing for third parties. By setting up your own funders and fees, you can create your own billing process and structure for the services that you provide. So you can use this no matter what profession you're in, what country you're in, you can set up and use this. So this example I'm going to use is a school services example. Let's just open this other one here. So let's say I am a practitioner and I am the school physician for different schools around the city. So I'm going to set up a funder that is customized to this, and I'm going to be billing invoices to each different school. So first let's set up the funder. On the left, so click finances, then fees. And then right up top, click funders. By the way, this is just an example. You can use this for any third-party billing, but you can apply this to any service or, and you can have as many funders as you need to. You don't have to follow it this way exactly. So under funders, on the top right, click add funder. And let's just call this school services. And we're going to create a default patient claim, which means that every time you add a fee under this funder to a patient appointment, that patient's going to be going to have a claim created for them automatically. So under funder type, I'm going to set this to third party body. This automatically configures the billing structure. And under identification, you have to enter the label for whatever ID that you need to provide on this invoice. So it could be like your APRA number, provider number, but it has to be the label. You don't have to, add the actual number yet. That's going to go on the invoice. And then for payer, we're going to set this to organization. Now you have different options here for how you want to bill organization. Organization you invoice means it's going to, every time you create an appointment, that's a separate invoice by itself. So it creates a new invoice for that patient. Organization existing invoice, same patient means individual patient, it's going to be collated to the same invoice. So if you have this, you're going to see this one student this week and you're going to see that same student next week. All their appointments are going to go under the same invoice, but just for that patient. Organization existing invoice any patient means any patient for that organization. So for example, I'm going to, let's say, Melbourne Grammar School, and I'm going to see a bunch of students there as patients. All of those students are going to go under the same invoice. It's going to be automatically collated. So let's say I'm going to use that. So I just want to bill the organization once. So I'll select existing invoice, any patient. And then underpaying organization, I am just going to leave this blank. If it was going to be the same paying organization every time under this funder, then I would set a paying organization here. But since it's going to be different for each student, I'm going to leave this blank. So I'm just going to click save. So now we have our funder. We need to set up our fee that we're going to add to the appointment. So let's click fees here at the top. And let's click new fee on the top right. And let's enter our funder here, school services. Let's select that. And let's call the fee student checkup. And we'll set it to 15 minutes. And then for pricing, let's say $50, and let's set the rebate to the same amount. So that's how much you're going to get from the paying organization. And then let's save that fee. Okay, so now we have our fee. Let's start creating appointments. So let's go back to the calendar by clicking the Halaxy logo and say here on Friday, we're going to see our first student, and let's add them as a new patient. And then let's add that fee, school services, and then let's click save. So from here, we can add the students' claim. So let's say who's the paying organization? So what school are they from? So let's add, say, Melbourne Grammar. And payer is fine. So reference number, this can be like the identifier for the student that they are a student of that school. So maybe this can be their student number. So let's just add that number there. And then when you click on the invoice from the appointment panel, let's open that invoice. And we can add, see if you can see, this is the label that we added earlier in the funder settings. So just click the pencil icon and let's add APRA number. So the invoice for our first patient. Now let's add a second patient. Let's go back to the calendar. And then let's say second student. Let's add them. And then type school services, click save. Same thing, we'll add their their ID number, sorry, their student number. And when you open the invoice, oh shoot, sorry, forgot to add in their pay, the claim. Sorry, let me do that again. Bear with me a few minutes. So let's go back to second student. And if I add their claim, they have to be under the same paying organization. So I'm going to put that as Melbourne Grammar. So when you go to the invoice, this should be showing the same. This should be collating, basically. Hang on. Sorry, everybody. Bear with me. Let's try here. There you go. So you can see that these students now have their invoices collated, and then you can send this off to the school when you're ready to bill them. So you can use this structure for different third parties. So it can be a funding organization, it can be an employer. This is completely customizable for you. Again, you can edit what label this is, how many, you can add two more identification requirements. This can be completely customized for your practice. So another automation I wanted to show you is how you prefer your invoices, and also how to automatically send them. So obviously sending invoices can be really repetitive and tedious. There are two ways to send invoices automatically on Halaxy. You can send an unpaid invoices to follow up on payments, and you can send paid invoices as a receipt. So we can set that up in the payment settings. So on the left side, on the sidebar, click settings and then payments. So let's first set up paid invoices. So under invoice automation, you'll see that there's a group level. Let's click on the pencil icon here. So you can also set the default invoice payer. By default, invoices are always billed to the patient. But if you have, let's say, patients who are dependents, like children, you might want to bill the primary contact, such as the parent or guardian. By setting primary as the default payer, if you do have patients who don't have a primary contact, the patient will still be billed by default. This is just for patients that do have a primary contact. So we can enable that. And then there's also here invoice email automation. So if you want to send the paid invoices automatically, click automatic. Then you can select which types of invoices to email automatically. And if you only want to send when the rebates are successful, and if there are any fees you want to exclude. So we're just going to save that. Sorry, let me just. Real quick, I'll just use this account. So let's use the primary contact. So if you go back to the invoice and say you create an appointment for a patient who has a primary contact, by the way. And when you open the invoice, you'll see that their primary contact is automatically billed. So you can set their primary contact. You can set the primary contact in the patient's profile. If you click the patient's name here, it'll take you automatically to the patient profile. You can add their primary contact here. Okay, so now that you've saved this means that every time an invoice is fully paid, that invoice is going to be sent to the patient or the primary contact if they have one. Another thing is to, the other way to send invoices, the unpaid invoices. So not everybody, not all patients are going to be sending their credit card details. You may need to send them the invoice to pay online or to make a bank transfer. How we do it here is you set a due date for invoices relative to the appointment date. So for example, you want the due date to be 3 days after the appointment. And then you can set up the email to send on the due date. So it'll automatically send 3 days after the appointment if the invoice still hasn't been paid for. So under invoice due date, click the pencil icon, and we're just going to enable the due date. And you can set how long after the appointment you want the due date to be. If you want the due date to be the same day as the appointment, you can just set this to zero. Or if you want to send the invoice prior to the appointment, you can set this to -2, and this will send the invoice 2 days before the appointment, where they can make make the payment. And let's enable send on due date. Again, you can choose what type of invoices you want to send, which fees you want to exclude, and you can also use a communication template. So for example, unpaid invoices. This is gonna include the payment link dynamic term, which takes them to the the invoice summary, which I showed you earlier, where they can set up the they can make the payment or the assignment of benefit. So we'll save that. So you've now automated sending paid invoices, and you've also automated the sending of unpaid invoices, which will send 2 days before the appointment. The other thing that you can also set up is your template invoice template preferences. So up here, still in payment settings, click the edit link here, and you can customize what information you want to display or hide from the invoice. So you can show when their next appointment is, the label on the invoice. So if you want the invoice to say receipt when it's paid, you can also set that here. You can show or hide pronouns, the appointment duration. So there's a lot of options here, and you can just save that. And that will apply to the whole group as well. And by the way, with invoice automation and for the invoice due date, just like payment and rebates processing, you can set up different settings for different locations or different practitioners. Okay, now that's done. We're gonna move on to our last topic, which is how to automate reports and campaigns. So reports can give you clear oversight of your practice performance, both as a healthcare provider and as a healthcare business. Now on the sidebar, there's a section here called reports. If you click that, you'll see the different, types of reports that you can run on Halaxy. So I'll just quickly run through some of these. So finances, you can have reports to track your income, unpaid invoices, credit card expiries, anything to do with tracking payments, rebates, and expenses. The Medicare report, this is an automatic report. You don't actually have to set anything up. If you process any Medicare bulk billing or DVA claims, this report automatically populates daily. And then patient reports allows you to generate a list of patients based on the filters you set around their patient info. So according to age, their birth date, gender, location, it's anything about the patient. Whereas appointment generates a list of patients based on filters you set around appointments and fees. So it's like, I want all the list of patients I'm seeing for smoking cessation, or treatment for smoking, or I want a list of patients that I saw last week. So it's a list of patients based on their appointments. Then referrals referral reports track referring practitioners. You can get a list of the referring practitioners by referral type, by patient, recipient practitioner, and also referral limits. So you can track, like, for example, which of your patients have one appointment left in the referrals, which I'm going to show you in an example later. Then lastly, communication reports track every communication sent by your practice, email, SMS, fax, campaigns, phone calls. You can track how many you've done. You can also track, for example, for emails, if your emails have sent or not, you can track their sent status. So just really quickly, I'm going to run you through a couple of examples. So first thing I'll show you is an unpaid invoices report. So if you click on reports and then finance, so this is where your list, you can have as many reports as you want to, and this is all still included in the free part of Halaxy. You don't need any credits to use this. So on the top right, click new report. And for report type, you can select what kind of report you, what kind of finance report you want to run. So for example, I want to see all the unpaid invoices, just a running tab of all the unpaid invoices. And let's say I just want just for myself, and I'm going to run this. So as of right now, there's none, but let's say, whenever you do have an unpaid invoice, this is going to automatically populate. So let's say this is something you want to check every month and you don't want to keep setting up like new report, setting all those filters. You can actually save this report by clicking save and just say unpaid invoices. And say you want this to be a regular report. So I want this to repeat every month. And say you can set it to run for only a set number of times, or after, or only until a specific date. So let's say until December, and then you select that, or you can remove the date and it's just going to run this report every month continuously. And you want to run it at, say, 11:59, and you click save. So now this, you have this report that's going to automatically generate every month. So that really saves you a lot of time. All you have to do is come here, click reports, finance. It's going to be in this list, and it's automatically going to generate here. So you'll have your updated report every month. The next example I'm going to show you, this is going to link closely to campaigns. So what I'm going to show is how to generate a report for patients with expiring referrals. And we are going to set up a campaign to notify those patients that, hey, you have one appointment left in your referral. Please get another one. So again, in reports, we're going to go to referral reports. And on the top right, we're going to click new report. So let's say, so we want the patients with one appointment left. So under limit, we're going to say equals one appointment remaining. And we also want to generate a list of these people have one appointment left and they have an appointment coming up. So they're really going to know that they're going to have to know that that's their last appointment on this referral. So I'm going to, under next appointment, under length, I'm going to say in 2 weeks. So these are people with one appointment left and they have an appointment within the next 2 weeks. So I'm going to run this referral. So now you can see that we have a patient who has one referral left, and then I'm going to click save. So I can save this report and refer to it again next time. It can be reused. So I'll say expiring referrals, and I am going to save it. So we have this report. we're going to set this as a campaign. So essentially, this report becomes like our target email list. So to use this as an email list, click set as campaign here up top. And this is going to be our campaign for expiring referrals. And we want to automate this to send automatically so that we don't have to keep running the report, send the email. This will be automatic on its own. So I've already set up a communication template because I don't want to run you through that again. That was part of our previous webinar. Again, Shane, can you drop in the link for the communication templates? So this is the expiring referrals communication template that just says, hi, patient name, you have one appointment left in your referral. Please obtain a new one from your GP. And so the recipient is going to be patients, send on behalf. And now we want this campaign to repeat because we want this to be automatic. So I'm going to repeat this every 1 week. And let's say we'll send this on a Monday. And then we want this to be ongoing. So because this is going to send every week, so let's say 1 week, the person still didn't get a new referral, they're going to receive another reminder the next week. So they'll get a maximum of 2 reminders before their appointment. So when you click save, you've successfully saved the campaign and it's scheduled to go. So every week, this campaign is going to refresh. This target list is also going to stay updated. So just with that, everybody who has one appointment left in the referral is going to be notified without you doing anything. So that's how you use a report and that's how you use campaigns. We have a list of useful campaigns that you can apply to your practice. Shane, can you drop a link on the useful campaigns? You can use this for greeting your patients on their birthdays. You can use this for recalls. You can use campaigns for automatically sending patient intake forms. So yeah, there's a lot that you can use with campaigns. And with automatic reports and campaigns, you can keep your practice efficient and Halaxy can take a lot of these repetitive tasks off your hands. So that's it for our webinar. We went through all the different kinds of automations that you can use for your admin. I really hope you enjoyed it and found it useful. From here on, managing your clinical billing will be much faster and more efficient. Just a reminder that this session is being recorded and you'll be emailed the link if you want to rewatch this or you want to send it to your colleagues. For future webinars, we also want to get your thoughts on what webinars you want to see. We'll be dropping a poll in the chat, so we'd appreciate it if you can answer. Give me one second. I'm going to drop the poll. So there's a poll now being launched. So if you can just answer that, we'd really appreciate it. We want to know your thoughts on what you want to see for our webinars, and make sure to check out our help guide support.halaxy.com for more exciting features and functions on Halaxy. We're always updating the release notes every month, and I'm going to be handing you back to Shane now. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you so much, Rhea. That was another great session, so really appreciate your time now. So we have a few more minutes to answer a few more questions if you have any for the team. So as we said before, if you have any further questions, just drop them in the chat. And our team will get back to you now. We'll just give you a couple of minutes to pop those questions in, and we would really appreciate your feedback. It helps us make these webinars and basically everything we do at Halaxy better. So please complete that feedback. Okay, we're ready to start with your questions.
Shraddha, yeah, you could send Medicare assignments automatically, but you would have to include the payment link dynamic term on the email template. And you would probably also want to send that only to bulk billed patients. Any other questions? Access telehealth. Dawn, for telehealth, you just have to create an appointment and set the location to Halaxy Telehealth. That'll automatically set it as a telehealth appointment. Yeah, Josh is sending you a link to the guide. Hi, Katrina. If you need to start from scratch with Halaxy, if you go to halaxy.com/webinars, we have our Getting Started with Halaxy webinar there. That's a great place to start. What's the best way to bill a patient without adding in a fee? Paul, what exactly do you want to bill them in the invoice if it's not a fee? But you can create, like, if you don't want to create an appointment, if you go to, I'll just show you real quick. So if you want to bill a patient without having to create an appointment, if you on the sidebar, click finances and then invoices, click new invoice up here on the top right, and then you can just add in your patient here. So, sorry. And then click save. And this creates an invoice that's separate from, that's not linked to any appointment. David, your question, when the auto paid invoice is set up, can we define the email comm template? Yes, and you'll find that in the reminder settings. So I'll show you real quick now. Under settings and then reminders, you'll see here on the right, under templates, there's an invoice email here. Just click edit for that. This is the email that gets sent to patients when they're paid in, when they're in, for paid invoices. Any other, I think you can be organized. Yeah, I think we've got the questions. So Shane,
yeah, I think
we've back to you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Rhea. If you have any further questions, you can always send them to community@halaxy.com and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. So what's next? We've had a great series of onboarding webinars with Rhea, and we really appreciate that, Rhea. And as I mentioned at the start, this is the last webinar in our new onboarding series. But if you missed the first few webinars as part of this series, or if you simply want to revisit them, I have dropped the link in the chat so you can view them there. And going forward, when we host new webinars, we'll announce them via email, our blog, and Facebook. So keep an eye out on those channels if you do want to watch them. And as Rhea mentioned before, we will use your feedback to shape what webinars we will hold next. So it's really valuable and really useful for us. And while this was the final webinar as part of the series, we're always releasing new features and improvements to Halaxy. And like our webinars, we'll announce these via email, our blog, and Facebook. So keep an eye out for those if you're interested in what we're doing at Halaxy. And we are also planning to release a ton of educational videos over the next 6 to 12 months. These aren't live learning experiences like our webinars, but they will cover some of the most important topics in Halaxy and really help you get up to speed with them. So this is something, if you want to subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is where we'll be hosting these, you can view them there. And last but certainly not least, Rhea is always adding new and helpful content to Halaxy's help guide. And while I'm sure many of you on this call have already discovered the help guide for yourself, if you haven't, it really is a great resource when it comes to making the most of Halaxy in its 400 plus guides, videos, and tutorials on every area of Halaxy you need to run and automate your practice. Plus, we also release our release notes there, which cover all the new features we are making and adjusting at Halaxy. I mean, every time I open the help guide, I feel like I learn something new. So if you're using Halaxy Daily, I highly recommend you bookmark that one. And that's it. We really appreciate you joining today's session. I know I've learned a lot over the last few months, and I hope everyone has as well. If you have any further questions, you can always reach out to our customer service team. They are here to help you Monday to Friday, 24 hours a day, Australian Eastern Standard Time. Well, I hope everyone enjoys the rest of their day. Goodbye.
Bye.
Bye, Rhea.